What's going on? Where do I begin? There's a kind of a thought right now, and lately it's been attacking all of the athletes, all of the children, and I know sometimes I think they get unwarranted. You know, sometimes it's unwarranted, right? Sometimes it's not fair. Sometimes we got to pull back layers and look at ourselves, right? As coaches, as leaders, and mentors that are trying to shape these young kids, teenagers, young men, young women. Young humans' outlook, right? And the thing is, we always say that they're not coachable, right? These kids don't listen these days. They're not doing X, Y, and Z. I think those days are gone. And not saying that the kids are not coachable, but I think, right, they're demanding a new level of coaching. So what I mean by that is simple. Like, you can't just go and say, hey, do this, do that, right? And not explain it to them, right? Or maybe even better yet, how about earn their trust as well? Right, we have this, you know, that we become a coach or that we're just an adult, that the players automatically, all right, even just even not even players, not even athletes, that the kids that below are younger than us, right? Not below, because nobody's below anybody, but younger than us just deserve our respect automatically. And I'm not saying that nobody should just come and disrespect you, but that they should automatically listen to you, right? I think now. The days of just do this, do that are over, and that we have to build that wall of trust, right? What's going to make that player, that person, run through a wall for you, right? How do you communicate, right? How do you know what's going on in their daily life? And I think these are the things that we are just missing across the board. Oh, this player doesn't want to listen. Oh, he just is not engaged. Well, why is he not engaged? What's going on in his house, right? Is there something bothering him, right? I think. These are things as coaches, right? As leaders, I don't care if you're in the job field, right? As a boss, that we need to be more present about. There is so much going on in the world besides the job, besides the sport, besides whatever, right? So I challenge me. It's always a challenge, and I think the biggest thing I've done and I've learned is, hey, I gotta lead by example. So if I want you to trust me, the first thing I'm gonna do, I'm gonna grab you. I'm gonna be vulnerable. I'm gonna be open first, right? That's, hey, what's going on in your life? Hey, this is how I grew up, right? Maybe this is how I communicate. How do I push you? Or do you even find out though if your athlete likes to be yelled at or did it like to be talked to? There's so many things and so many variables that I feel like that we're just attacking the kids and the youth, saying they're not this or they're not that, when the way we have grown up has changed. And to be honest, as a former player, right, I hated when a coach never explained why to me. I got in trouble all the time. Like, if it didn't make sense, I'm gonna ask why. And sometimes that would be looked at as I'm not bought in or I'm not this. Well, just explain it to me, right? Or maybe earn my trust, you know? And I'll share a story too. A couple of years, not a couple of years ago, but years ago in college, around my sophomore year, or my junior year, I should say, I had a major slump, right? And that was all through family issues. And we will get into that later. But the point is, right? Earn the trust, earn the athlete's trust, earn your employee's trust if you're a boss, right? Be there, be intent, be aware, right? See what's going on, care for them, right? The minute they truly know that you care and it's not just a job, you're just showing up to do this, it's not about wins and losses, I'm telling you, it will be a much better place. So let's stop attacking these kids. They want to be coached. I promise you, they want to be great. They do. Do they not have all the answers? No, but neither did we, right? And if that's the case, we wouldn't be still on this life journey to be great. So, right, we have to stop judging 17-year-old teenagers. We have to stop judging. Like, let's help them grow. Let's talk to them, right? Let's never give up, because there's times it's tough.
So I've been there. And if you feel that you've exhausted all resources, right, with your time, your effort, not maybe showing trust, maybe recommend them to somebody you know in your network that could help this person. But the biggest thing and the biggest message that I wanted to get through is make sure that what you want, your students, your athletes, your employees, whatever, that the direction you want them to listen to and receive you, that you're giving it back. So the biggest thing is communication, right? And trust and breaking down those walls so that it's easy to be coachable, to be successful, and then just and overall communicate so everybody's on the same page. So don't expect somebody to just come in and trust you right away and you're not given the And you're not given the tools or the trust back so that those walls can be broken. So let's stop blaming our youth. Let's look into us first. What can we do better? Once we do that, I think a lot of barriers and a lot of walls will be broken. Thank you. I hope you find this encouraging.
And let's try to get out here and let's make everybody great. Another day to be great. Let's enjoy it.